Hello everybody and welcome to my first video in about 2 weeks. We've had a busy week everybody. As you all know, it has been E3 week over in downtown Los Angeles, California. If you guys don't know, which you probably should at this point, E3 is the biggest gaming event of the year, where we get to see brand new games, brand new additions to games, and brand new peripherals to consoles. Yes. Well, I'm here to rank the top 10 games, in my opinion, of course. I want to make that clear, because chances are you guys are going to disagree with this list. And I understand that. That's part of life. That's how people work. But I'm here to tell you that you're wrong and I'm right. So, here we go. Pokemon Super Mystery Dungeon. Now, let me just make this clear. The newest Pokemon Mystery Dungeon game was complete and utter booty. It was terrible. Gates to Infinity, what was it called? It was awful, but I have big hopes for this next Pokemon Mystery Dungeon game. One, it said that you can capture, I don't really know if you capture in this, recruit? You can recruit every Pokemon ever made, I guess, in this one, which seems cool, and it seems like it's going back to the basics, because, I mean, you can play as anything, you're not restricted to just your starter. You can evolve, it seems, because, I mean, you gotta get them all somehow. And I'm just super excited for this, because I feel like it could be the return to the Explorers games and the original, because those are some of the best spin-off. I would go as far to say Explorers of Sky, at least, is probably the best Pokemon spin-off of all time. So, I got high hopes for this game, and I'm hoping that it turns out great. Cuphead. Now, this game is really weird. This is the first indie game I've really had at an E3 that's like, dang, I want to play this now. When I was little, I used to always watch cartoons and think, man, one day I want to be able to play a game that looks like as smooth as a cartoon. I feel like I'm playing in a cartoon, like Tom and Jerry or something. And this is exactly that. Like, everything you're seeing right now is not an animated segment. This is actual gameplay. The game actually looks like this, and that's just super cool to me. This comes out early next year, and I am super excited to try it out. I don't really have much to say else about it, except that it looks awesome. And I'm gonna play, just look at that. That looks sick. I wanna do that right now. I don't know. Tell me what you guys think about it, but I think it looks awesome. Alright, next up, I broke the rules, because screw it. We got two games. Two different console exclusives. Right now you're seeing Horizon Zero Dawn. This game is a PlayStation 4 exclusive, as far as I know, I'm like 99% sure. And it's very different. Basically, it's like, what if instead of having to hunt for food and hunt for natural resources, we had to hunt for technology? Yeah, it's crazy. Probably Japanese stuff, I would assume. But yeah, it looks cool, looks interesting, and I'm excited. I don't really know much about it other than that there's mechanical dinosaurs in the wild. I'm sold. I need it now. And then Recore's game, we didn't actually get any true gameplay for, but it is coming out early next year on Xbox One exclusively. It's from the Metroid Prime developers, I think, which is pretty sick. It is a... we don't know. We actually don't know what it is, but it looks cool from the trailer, and so I'm excited. It looks like the dog goes jihad. You can put the jihad dog in other things to make it also become a jihad. This is my interpretation, but I want it. So, yeah. So this is gonna be a controversial pick, but for number 7, I got Guitar Hero Live. And the reason I have this over Rock Band 4, which I'm still somewhat excited for, is I was always a huge Guitar Hero fan back in the day over Rock Band, and Guitar Hero Live is the newest entry in the series, a complete reboot. Rock Band 4, you can keep all your old instruments, keep all your old songs. Guitar Hero Live ditches that, which I guess is probably a negative for most people, including myself somewhat. But they do introduce something completely new, which is there's a completely new guitar, completely new gameplay, completely new style of the game, which I like over Rock Band 4, because Rock Band 4 is keeping it really safe, which I can respect. But Guitar Hero Live is taking a risk, and I sort of like it. I'm excited for the new guitar design, and I really want to try it out. So next up, at number 6, I got Battleborn. Now, if you guys don't know much about this game, it is the newest entry, Well, no, I wouldn't say entry. That's not the right word. It's the newest game by the Borderlands developers. And you can pretty much consider it Borderlands 3, even though they are making Borderlands 3. This is like their new in-between game that I guess is like sort of a spin-off from it, even though it's nothing to do with the original story. This is Battleborn. And instead of being weapons-based, it seems to be more character-driven in terms of your level-up design, but the gameplay may be similar to Borderlands 2. I really don't know much about it, but I really like the art style, and I really like sort of the idea of where it's headed. And Borderlands has always impressed me, besides the newest one, pre-sequel. But the game has always been so much fun. 2K and Gearbox have always made a great game that's very fun and funny at the same time. And so I'm super excited to see the game and see how it turns out. And I'm not sure, I think it does come out this year. And I really want to try it and see if it is what I think it will be, which is hopefully a fun game that I can pour a lot of hours into like I did Borderlands 2. Alright, hold on, don't dislike the video, I can already see him coming out because I put a Call of Duty game on my top 10 list over your favorite random Japanese RPG. But listen to me for a second, if you ever asked me any other year if I would put a Call of Duty on this list, the answer would have been no. There's never been a Call of Duty that impressed me at E3. Even Black Ops 2, which I would say is probably my favorite Call of Duty ever, over Modern Warfare 2, it would not have been on the list the year it was at E3, because I wouldn't have cared about it. But this year, they had enough confidence in the game so far to show off the multiplayer at E3, even though they usually wait till like August to do it. And my favorite multiplayer in Call of Duty ever was Black Ops 2, and the great thing about this game is that it looks just like Black Ops 2, with adding in some Destiny elements, which is what I enjoy. Which is a game that I really do enjoy. As you can see, they got the specialist thing in Black Ops 3 now, which is changing up the game. You can like pick your character and you get like a super ability similar to similar to Destiny. And there's tons of different characters, like 8 or so, and they each have different abilities, each have different customization. And if this game is anything like Black Ops 2, I am going to love this game, and I am so excited. It really does suck for me that they switched over DLC exclusivity to PlayStation, because even though I do want a PlayStation, I'm planning on getting one sometime early next year. I'm an Xbox Call of Duty player, and I think Xbox will always should be the home of Call of Duty, in my opinion. But hey, what PlayStation gets a DLC first for once? And I'm really hoping the game's great. I really hope this sort of revives Call of Duty. I feel like the last two games weren't too well received. I think this game could really help bring it back, which would be awesome. Alright, well technically not an entirely new game like everything else on this list, Destiny has easily been my favorite game of the past year. I'm gonna make an entire video pretty soon talking about how Destiny brought me back, because I was in Destiny like the first 3 months, then I got really out of it, thought it was dumb, but then it brought me back. I'm gonna make a video on how it did that, and how other games could learn from it, but I'm super excited for the Taken King expansion for Destiny. Now the reason it has its own slot on the list is because the expansion is big enough to count as an entirely new game, pretty much, even though it's inside of Destiny 1. Now, the game is, the way Destiny's improved lately, it's really listening to the players, and so I'm really excited to see where Taken King is headed. From everything that I've seen so far, it looks awesome. They're listening to everything that people have asked for, brand new subclasses for characters. I get to have a void bow as a hunter, which if you know me, that's all that I care about. If that's all I'm ever gonna use in this game, like screw my other characters. If I got a void bow, it's done. I'm not gonna use anything else. So, that's a pro and a con, because now I'm going to be stuck with Void Bow for the rest of my life, because I know myself. But, yep, Destiny Taken King looks very, very fun. I'm excited. Hope it's good. Good luck finding a top 10 E3 list where you won't find this game. Honestly, if I look at it from an objective standpoint, not just from my own opinion on games I already like, this game should be number one. It was easily the biggest stunner of E3. The game looks incredible. It looks so much fun. And I'm beyond excited for it. This is where we get to the area of the list where I'm definitely gonna get this game. Like, this game looks so good. It's improved everything from Fallout 3, from colors, to characters, to like voice acting, to gameplay itself. Like, there's nothing wrong with this game that I've seen. It looks incredible. And anybody you ask is going to say the same thing. This game looks absolutely incredible. And I'm going to be getting this day one. You all should too. Fallout 4, it's going to be probably the biggest game of the year. And if you don't know, if you're not very big on games, this is from the same people that made Skyrim. Other Elder Scrolls games, besides Elder Scrolls Online, which we don't talk about. and yeah, everything like that. Fallout 4 is going to be huge. I recommend you get it. It's going to be great. If you know me, you already knew this was coming. I am a huge Halo fan. And if you asked me earlier this year if I was that excited for Halo 5, I would have told you no. I played the beta and I was really unimpressed. I did not like it that much at all. I felt it was really trying to be too much like Call of Duty. But then they brought it to E3 this year and they explained the changes that they've made since the beta. And ignoring multiplayer for a second, the story looks incredible. I'm so excited to find out what happens next in the story because I'm a Halo lore idiot nerd who wants to know all about where Master Chief's going, what's going on, who's doing what. The multiplayer, while I didn't like it earlier this year, they're bringing back just tons of like classic stuff. Like they're getting rid of loadouts, which is great. They're changing up the game in a way that actually makes sense. And when I really consider it in terms of the sort of elements they're bringing from their shooters, it sort of makes sense when I look at it. And then they brought in a brand new mode entirely called Warzone, which you're seeing right now. And what that is it's a replacement to like Big Team Battle, even though I'm sure they'll still have classic Big Team Battle in there. Warzone is a complete mix of player versus enemies from like campaign. It's the entire Halo thing all in one. And it looks really fun and really awesome. And like you can, all the DLC maps for Halo 5 are gonna be free. And to replace that, you can like get like, what's it called? Like REQ bundles or something. So like get like skins for your guns and all that. Even though you can earn everything through regular gameplay, you can get like a head start with these bundles or whatever, which is sick because you don't have to play any extra if you really don't want to. But if you do, like me probably, because I'm a huge Halo fan, then you can. And Halo 5 is going to be great, man. Like, I really, I can't guarantee that, but I really hope it is. From everything that I've seen, I think it's going to be really, really good. I feel like the reason Microsoft dropped the Call of Duty contract is because they have so much faith in Halo, which is awesome. If they really have faith in Halo 5, that'll be a good competitive game, that'll be a good single-player game all around, then I could see this Halo becoming as big as Halo 3. And that's saying something, because Halo 3 was a phenomenon that only comes around once in a blue moon. This game could become that, and I'm very excited for it. Now I'm sure you're wondering, what could be number one? Now let me make this clear. There are very few things in this world that can make me cry like a little girl. One is shots, and two is Star Wars. Let me tell you, that day I did not have any shots, but I cried like a little girl. This is a game that I have been waiting for over 10 years, no, longer than that even. Since Star Wars Battlefront 2, I wanted Star Wars Battlefront 3. Now when I heard this game is being made by DICE and EA, it was like, oh man, so many things could go wrong. We don't know, it could be terrible. But oh my god, I have never been so impressed by a little bit of gameplay in my entire life. This game looks incredible. It is easily my most, the game I'm looking forward to most this year, but maybe even of all time. I used to look on this website, StarWarsBattlefront3.net, I think it was, for the past 10 years, every single year, being disappointed. Being like, oh, Battlefront 3 will never happen. It's never gonna happen. Could it be this year at E3? Nope, it wasn't. But 2 years ago, it was. And this year, it really was. Oh my god. I can't... There's nothing I need to say. Like, the sounds are incredible. It feels like you're in a Star Wars movie, if you even just watch the trailer. The sounds are straight out of the movies. It's so true to Star Wars. I'm so excited. I'm even building my entire channel around this when this comes out. I'm so excited for this stupid game. Like, that's all I have to say. Like, this video's done. Star Wars, it gets number one. It gets number 1 to 10. Screw all the other games. Star Wars, dude. If you'd excuse me.
Star Wars!
Alright, I just want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. It took a while to make, you know, not some of my best content. There were some editing quirks along the way. I had to make it, you know, in just under about 3 hours. But I really appreciate you guys watching, and I finally figured out what liking and, like, favoriting does for my channel. It really does help, guys. So if you enjoyed the video whatsoever, I really appreciate the like and the favorite or whatever you want to do. Even just commenting helps me, guys. Helps me too, guys, because it lets me know that you guys are listening, that you do care. And that means a lot. So you guys can click one of the two videos on the screen if you really want. If you haven't seen them yet, I recommend it. All right, thank you guys. I'm out.